physics conflict with each other? What issue arises from quantum physics equations that complicates unification? How do scientists attempt to resolve infinite values in quantum physics? Why is adjusting equations to fit observations problematic? What does Einstein's equation E equal mc squared imply about virtual particles and mass? What potential consequence does infinite mass pose for the universe? This is A Brief History of Time by Stephen Hawking. Situation where the universe shrinks and time reverses. How would that play out? Maybe clocks tick in reverse and history goes back. While scientists haven't totally dismissed it, three compelling clues point to time moving only forward. The first indication that time flows from past to future is the thermodynamic arrow of time. According to the second law of thermodynamics, entropy, or the disorder within a closed system, tends to increase over time. This implies that time's passage can be tracked by the natural tendency of disorder to grow. For instance, consider a cup falling from a table and shattering. This event leads to decreased order and higher entropy. The fact that a shattered cup won't magically reassemble and become more orderly shows that time only progresses in one direction. The broken cup and the thermodynamic arrow of time also relate to the second indicator of forward time, the psychological arrow guided by memory. Once the cup has broken, you can remember it being on the table, but before it fell, when it was still on the table, you can't recall its future position on the floor. The third indicator, known as the cosmological arrow of time, relates to the expansion of the universe, aligning with our perception of the thermodynamic arrow. As the universe expands, entropy increases. If disorder in the universe were to reach its maximum, the universe might begin contracting, reversing the cosmological arrow of time. However, we would be unaware of this reversal, because intelligent life can only exist as disorder increases. This is due to our reliance on entropy to break down food into usable energy. Therefore, as long as we're around, we will observe the cosmological arrow of time as going forward. What kinds of forces are at work in the universe? Most people are familiar with only one force. Gravity, the force that attracts objects to each other, experienced as Earth's gravity pulling us toward its surface. However, most people are unaware that there are actually three additional forces that act on the smallest particles. The first is the electromagnetic force, visible in daily life when a magnet sticks to a refrigerator or when you charge your phone. It acts on all particles with electric charges, like electrons and quarks. The electromagnetic force, similar to the attraction and repulsion between the north and south poles of a magnet, can either attract or repel. Positively charged particles attract negative ones and repel other positive particles, and vice versa. This force is significantly stronger than gravity and is dominant at the atomic level. For instance, the electromagnetic force causes an electron to orbit around an atom's nucleus. The second force is the weak nuclear force, which acts on the particles that compose matter and is responsible for radioactivity. It is termed weak because the particles that carry it can only exert force over very short distances. At higher energies, the strength of weak nuclear force increases until it matches that of electromagnetic force. The third is the strong nuclear force, which holds protons and neutrons together in an atom's nucleus and binds the smaller quarks within them. Unlike the electromagnetic and weak nuclear forces, the strong nuclear force weakens at higher energies. At a very high energy level known as grand unification energy, the electromagnetic force and weak nuclear force become stronger, while the strong nuclear force weakens. At this point, all three forces achieve equal strength and manifest as different aspects of a single force, which may have played a role in the creation of the universe. Most scientists believe time began with the Big Bang, when the universe transitioned from an infinitely dense state to its current rapid expansion. Scientists, however, don't exactly know how this Big Bang occurred, although a number of theories have been proposed to explain how this huge expansion might have happened. The most widely accepted theory of the universe's beginning is the Hot Big Bang model. In this model, the universe originated from a point of zero size that was infinitely hot and dense. During the Big Bang, it expanded and cooled as its heat dispersed. Most of the elements present in the universe today were formed within the first few hours of this expansion. As the universe continued to expand, gravity caused denser regions of the expanding matter to start rotating, creating galaxies. Within these newly forming galaxies, clouds of hydrogen and helium gases collapsed. Their colliding atoms caused nuclear fusion reactions, which created stars. When these stars later died and collapsed, they created huge stellar explosions that ejected more elements into the universe. This provided the material for the birth of new stars and planets. Although this is the generally accepted version of the Big Bang and the birth of time, it's not the only model. Another model is the inflationary model, which suggests that the early universe's energy was so extraordinarily high that the strengths of the strong nuclear force, weak nuclear force, and electromagnetic force were equal. However, as the universe expanded, the three forces quickly assumed different strengths. When they separated, a tremendous amount of energy was released, resulting in an anti-gravitational effect that caused the universe to expand rapidly and at an increasing rate. In their quest to understand and explain the universe, scientists have developed two major theories. The first is general relativity, which focuses on a large-scale phenomenon, gravity. The second is quantum physics, which examines some of the smallest known entities in the universe, subatomic particles. Although both theories offer significant insights, there are considerable differences between the predictions made by quantum physics equations and those made and observed in general relativity. As a result, there is currently no method to combine them into a single unified theory of everything. One challenge in merging the two theories is that many equations in quantum physics yield seemingly impossible infinite values. For instance, the equation suggests that the curvature of space-time would be infinite, which observations have proven to be incorrect. To eliminate these infinities, scientists attempt to introduce additional infinities into the equations. Unfortunately, this hinders accurate predictions. As a result, rather than using quantum physics equations to predict events, scientists must adjust the equations to fit the observed events. A second similar problem is that quantum theory suggests that all the empty space in the universe is made up of virtual pairs of particles and antiparticles. However, the existence of these virtual pairs causes difficulties for general relativity. Since there is an infinite amount of empty space in the universe, the energy of these pairs would have to have infinite energy. This poses a problem because Einstein's well-known equation E equals mc squared indicates that an object's mass is equivalent to its energy. Therefore, if these virtual particles possess infinite energy, they would also have infinite mass. An infinite mass would lead to the entire universe collapsing under its immense gravitational pull, resulting in a single black hole.
in which energy is put equal to mass multiplied with the square of the velocity of light showed that very small amount of mass may be converted into a very large amount of energy, and vice versa. The mass and energy were in fact equivalent, according to the formula mentioned above. This was demonstrated by Cochra and Walton in 1932 experiment.